Fresh talk to him.
This is Spec Weekly. I'm Cutcraft, delivering your dose of IOTA Hopium. Join me as we take a look at what happened last week.
Read the disclaimer, baby.
Let's go. Today we're looking at the IOTA Cubon Progress Report, starting with IOTA Core. The IOTA Core team is responsible for delivering the IOTA 2.0 node software. It's pretty much the software that makes the Tangle work. The team optimized the software performance and adjusted the API. APIs allow independent systems to talk to each other. They're crucial for interconnectivity. The team has improved the API for use with Firefly, the Tangle Explorer, and the IOTA SDK. And this part right here is important. Emphasis has been placed on rigorously testing the node software across multiple large-scale deployments and under various load and attack conditions. This means they are already stress testing the consensus solution that doesn't have the coordinator. We are getting so damn close to be able to say, we did it. An important piece of work to support the IOTA 2.0 rollout is in the creation of libraries for builders. You can't just throw out the software without having pre-built functions for builders to leverage. Client libraries are crucial for streamlining the development process, and it means that developers aren't starting from scratch. The client libraries team have implemented the IOTA 2.0 Tangle improvement proposals in the Rust SDK, and are now supporting the IOTA Foundation managed Firefly wallet. And these are elements that need to be up and running before the IOTA 2.0 beta is released. The Layer 2 smart contracts team have optimized the native IOTA smart contracts protocol to be ready for IOTA 2.0. This is a reminder that we have a native IOTA-focused smart contract protocol. I know we might have forgotten all about it, because our smart contracts aren't just EVM, which focus on the Ethereum language Solidity. IOTA smart contracts automatically wrap and unwrap assets between the Tangle and Layer 2 IOTA-based chains, as well as seamlessly passing data between all IOTA-based Layer 2 chains and the Tangle. The tooling team builds infrastructure for apps that run directly on the Tangle, and their work over the past quarter has focused on the Explorer and the Firefly wallet. They are developing versions that are compatible with IOTA 2.0, and why? Well, hold on to your nipples. In anticipation of the 2.0 public testnet. It feels like we are so close, but after all these years and all of my antidepressants, it almost doesn't feel real. Great work by the Identity team, as we've seen the first version of Identity gRPC released, allowing the integration of IOTA Identity in any application stack, because the gRPC is language agnostic, meaning it can be used within any code base. This is incredible, as it makes widespread adoption significantly easier due to the Identity gRPC's flexibility. Identity is fixed into pretty much every mainstream use case. And I find it interesting because when I think of identity, my mind goes straight to picturing a human identity, a person. But identity can be used to recognize a machine, a car, a box of flowers, or maybe even an air fryer. Okay, is it SUSE or is it SUSE? Regardless, SUSE is the acronym for Secure Sensoring Platforms for Smart Energy Grids. And I didn't even know there was a team at the foundation for this. Amazing. It's amazing we have a team for this, because one of the narratives that we'll build over this bull run and for the coming years is for decentralized physical infrastructure. You might know it as DPIN. The SUSE team set up a SUSE node that contributes to the IOTA tech stack as a scalable solution for reliable and secure data transmission, and processing in sensor networks. Think of data that is collected from real-world phenomena, like a thermometer that monitors the temperature in a cargo truck. The team have successfully integrated the SUSE node into the LoRaWAN communication infrastructure with partner projects. Now, there must be some NDA stuff going on here because I have not heard anything about this. And I guess it just isn't as sexy as RWA tokenization right now. But let's keep it on the radar. Hopefully we see something cool pop up within the year. The ecosystem team has grown. This is in line with the foundation's commitment to nurture our ecosystem and bring in more talent and projects. The team architected the launch of IOTA Grants, which is now active and open for anyone to apply. The ecosystem team was also responsible for strategizing the smooth launch of the IOTA EVM, making sure all the moving parts fit together as intended for the upcoming public release. By the way, the IOTA EVM has been soft launched since March the 18th, meaning that smart contracts are already being deployed to the IOTA EVM that are connecting to the Layer 1 Tangle. And this soft launched EVM, it's the real deal. It's not a testnet. This is the mainnet version of the IOTA EVM. So technically it is live, but it just doesn't have the oracles and bridges and all that good stuff just yet. They're slowly building that up as we speak. All right. Trying to keep it short and snappy. As always, guys, I recommend you check out the full article at your own pace, as I've summarized things from my own frame of understanding, and as we already know, my brain is smoother than most. All right, I'm feeling that energy. You know, it's easy to overlook the things that have been done at the protocol level if we aren't actively engaging with the dApps that have launched in our ecosystem on the Shimmer EVM, for example. Shimmer is that testing ground. It's meant to show you what's going on, and you're meant to learn how to do DeFi, how to lose your money without it hurting too much. That is, if you didn't swap over your IOTA into Shimmer. But that Shimmer was airdropped for a staking period, and I guess it's on us to see how deep we want to go down that rabbit hole. And you know what? Active right now on Shimmer, we have decentralized exchanges like IOTA B, Shimmer C, and Tangle Swap. We have a lending platform with Deeper Finance and a yield aggregator with Accumulator, and we'll be introduced to futures trading when Pepe Finance launches. And that's the DeFi building blocks we'll have going live on the IOTA EVM within the coming months. Not to mention we have IOTA MPC bridging tokens between IOTA and Shimmer, and Layer 0 connecting us from Shimmer to 9 other chains. And apart from DeFi, we have GameFi with IOTA Heroes, Dark Mythos, IOTA Bots, and I was given a look at a real-time game that I think will be huge. It's going to be a true community standout, and it's called Salt Mines. Check out their Twitter. They haven't communicated much yet, but I've been shown a sneak peek, and it is going to be very, very cool. We have important projects like Epoch Zero leading the NFT culture, where they have built a silky NFT trading platform, giving people who hold their Pharaoh NFTs added functionality to do analysis on the Epoch Zero site. And on NFT collections, we see the likes of Rusty Robots, who are very active and building some cool tools and pushing to make a mark in music-related assets and royalties. The ApeDAO is going hard too. They invest the funds in their war chest on projects within our ecosystem. We've got esoteric NFT communities like Magic Meme Money bringing the dank culture. There are also art projects like Wasteland Warlords and Wasteland Sirens bringing some sexy flavor to our scene. Ultimately, we're developing a strong undercurrent of NFT communities, and it is super necessary.
I saw some criticism. People say the punches weren't really necessary. Maybe
they were super necessary.
And meme coins, bitch, have you been paying attention to why Solana is skyrocketing? Dog with Hat, Bonk, Book of Mean, Geo Bolden, Slurve. Are we too serious as a community to have fun like this? Well, we do have people trying to push this kind of culture with some interesting tokens. And I'll mention the Grumpy Squid project because my boy CryptoJ is super active in what he's developing, going as far as to create a decentralized raffle game for the degens out there. And he's also got some interesting tokenomics for what he's working on. Check it out if you want. And now back on the technical side, we have professional auditors with Audit One who are absolute guns when it comes to sanity checking smart contracts and leveling up our ecosystem's risk mitigation efforts. And I'm paying them to do the audits for the smart contracts of my project. Which brings me to teams like Acodus, who are the epitome of professionals in every sense. Their DLT team are able to innovate on any given idea, and I'm speaking firsthand as they are partners to my projects, the New Elites.
Power. Influence. To be one of the elite, you must be ready to take what is yours.
This is the groundswell of things to do with our ecosystem that aren't related to institutional and mainstream adoption. While sure, the reason we all bought in to begin with was that institutional adoption, standardization, and we're still going to see that with RWA and decentralized infrastructure, and also SASE, as I mentioned before. It is coming, and yes, this adoption will drive up IOTA's value more impactfully than meme coins, DeFi, NFTs and GameFi. However, meme coins, DeFi, NFTs and GameFis are crypto, and they are currently the most visible and engaged elements of crypto. Ignoring them would be shooting ourselves in the dick. And I don't know about you, but I like our collective penis and vaginas for the ladies out there. Now, this episode wasn't meant to be about ecosystem projects. It's about what the IF have achieved in Q1. I'm just pointing out that all this stuff that we already have and continue to have are super important for us to grow as an ecosystem, and they would be impossible without what has already been accomplished. So to anyone who says the IF doesn't deliver, instead of listing off what has already been deployed, all that stuff that I just mentioned, just tell the dude to go fuck himself. All right. With all that having been said, I'll be changing the format from the next episode. I need to start now focusing on hype and trying to get traction outside of our bubble. Most people don't really want to listen to 15 to 20 minutes of a detailed explanation of what's happening in somebody else's ecosystem. So from the next Spec Weekly, I'll open with 5 minutes of general crypto news, try to get some new eyes. Then I'll do an IOTA focus section where I go in less detail about things, and I'll do a recap of what's happening in our ecosystem. So 50%, this is what's going on in crypto, and 50%, this is what's happening in IOTA. I do it because working on my NFT project is so time intensive, it's stressful, and I need to make the process for Spec Weekly more efficient, and I guess more accessible to people outside of our bubble. So yes, let's keep the ball rolling, my boys. And man, I can't believe we're in a bull market. We rode out the bear market together, guys. Fucking congratulations, man. It was friggin' hard, and now things are looking up. And if you're still holding your entire bag, I salute you. Heck, if you were smart enough to DCA during the bear, I give you massive props. I know I wasn't. Well, one, because I had no money. It was already fucking aped into IOTA. But if you're able to overcome that fear and DCA at low, low prices, you are a Chad. The best time to buy is always when it feels like the game is completely over. Inversely, the best time to take profits is when you start to think your bag is going to make you a millionaire. So keep your eyes on that. Do a sentiment check every now and then and see how confident you are. The more confident you are, yeah, you probably should be thinking about selling. But yes, it was an immense support to have you guys around when I felt like I was going to die of poverty. But now the tide is turning, and I'm more convinced than ever that we're going to make it. So, if the CMC rank has got you feeling down, all you have to do is remember. $4 EOY. See you next time.